All right, the Reds, it's talking Reds, and the Reds are still flying, the Reds are still top. The Reds are 19 points clear in January at the top of the league with 70 points. Did some maths last night.
Did you?
Yeah.
How was that for you?
I was sitting up doing some maths. I was writing a little Facebook post, because I always write one now, post-match, have a look at them. And yeah, I was thinking, because I knew, 70 points in January is absolutely wild. So I was thinking, there's definitely been lots of full seasons where we didn't get 70 points. Mm. So I had a look. And since we last won the title, there's been 18 seasons where we didn't get 70 points. 18 seasons out of 30 years.
Oh my God.
So that's
18?
Yeah.
When was the most recent one? Can you remember?
I put it on the Facey so I can check for you. But basically, there was some really recently. I mean, under Dalglish, I think we got 53. Something like that.
Surely the season we finished eighth has got to be up there.
When there was a Rafa one as well, I think we in the Champions League spots and stuff like that, but we only got 68 points.
It's mad, that
in the whole season, not 70 points in January with 14 matches to play. 14 matches to play, by the way, and only 8 wins required max. And obviously, we have actually got to play City pretty soon as well, so we can get it wrapped up early. We all sort of know that. I think all the people now as well who are sort of, don't jinx it and don't say that and blah, blah, blah. I think you've got to enjoy yourself now. You've got to get on. You've got to get on board. Enjoy the ride. Enjoy every single game. I mean, someone said to me the other day about, and this was a game the other week, they were like, can't wait for the game on there at the weekend because we can win the league again. And it's like, that's what it feels like. It's like every time Liverpool play, we've won the league again. We won the league again last night.
We're 19 points clear and got 70 points and it's not even the end of January yet. Why are people even hesitating anymore? Stop saying if and start saying when. So what I've been saying, and I'm going to reiterate it, is for me personally, how I am preparing for Liverpool to win the league is texting my hairdresser and booking in for like a curly blow every weekend, because I could be out every weekend here, like watching it, do you know what I mean? Waiting for us to win the league. And then as the Anfield draft, we get asked to do loads of media and stuff. So then I can make my hair last over the next day, you know, like if I've got to go and do telly and stuff.
Me and Sam are laughing at curly blowing. You
know? Why are you laughing? What's wrong with a curly blow? Are you serious? Tell me what's wrong with a curly blow.
No, girl, you carry on.
Blow is when you get your hair done and get it blown with a hairdryer curly. I don't know what you're thinking, Mr. Immature, and what you're thinking. I thought I was being dead strategic and you've completely just like made a show with me idea. It's a really serious thing.
Anyway, I've looked up what you were on about now, right? And in 2016...
Not asked anymore.
In 2016... we got 60 points. The season before it was 62, in 2012 we got 52, and in 2011 we got 58, and so on and so on and so on and so on. So what I'm saying is, these are great times, and if you want to get a curly blow to prepare for Liverpool winning,
get as many curly blows as you want.
You fill
curly blows for everyone.
You fill your boots. Listen, we've got a high up in the show. I want to mention that this excellent top. Are from Luke 1977. We are doing a bit of a thing with them. Great set of lads, footy fans. They're doing a lot of footy tie-ups. They've done stuff with Villa, Hibernian, Kidderminster Harriers, I think Walsall as well, looking to do more stuff as well. But it's not just about football, it's obviously like casual wear, stuff you can wear when you're going out for a bevy, stuff you can wear day to day. Loads of good stuff on there. This top that Lizzie's wearing is called the Dalglish, after the man himself. So, you know, you get the vibe, like the lads who like to wear decent clobber, they're into the footy. We've been having conversations with them. I like them, I get on with them. I want to do them a bit of a favour. And obviously we're doing a bit of business as well. So what we've negotiated with them is a 15% off their full price gear. If you're watching this video, basically, so look in the description. It'll all be explained to you there. There's a code you can put in. There's a link for you to visit. Have a look at the full price stuff, and then you can get 15% off. If you are an Anfield Wrap subscriber, you can get 20% off, so an extra 5% off on top. To find out about that deal, go into the subscribers group that we've got on Facebook, and I've put all the details in there already. If you're not on Facebook and you can't be arsed with Facebook, but you want that deal and you are a subscriber, just give me a shout. in all the ways that you can, you know what I mean, Twitter or whatever, or email or whatever, and I'll tell you, basically. But yeah, that's the deal, check it out. They're about to launch their spring summer stuff as well, so there'll be a load more stuff on there as well soon, so check it out. Like I say, decent stuff, and I'm not just saying that, used to buy it anyway.
It's really good quality as well, like it sounds, isn't it, especially for the money. I was looking like with the 20% off, it's really, it's a boss little deal, like to get the 20% off.
Yeah, it's honestly sound, and like, you know, I'm no big salesman, as you've probably gathered over the years, but I do genuinely like this stuff. Anyway, so what else we've got to talk about? Well, let's talk about the Reds last night. It was just sort of so run-of-the-mills wrong, but at no point in the 90 minutes were you in doubt that Liverpool were going to win, were you?
I keep calling it routine, and I know everyone has this cliche of a routine 2-0, but it was exactly that last night. It just never in doubt, it was never on the edge, it was just us watching our boss football team. It felt like a champion's performance to me last night, and I don't mean as in like blowing everyone's socks off. It was just controlled, every single player played a part. It was really quite hard to pick man of the match last night. I think if you argue Joe Gomez sound, if you argue Jordan Henderson, if you argue Firmino, Salah, you could make a case for every single one of them. And they just done the business, they just got it done, and I think you could clearly tell all this idea of it being a hoodoo from last season, obviously when we went and got the draw there, and it was the set piece that done us winning it, and it was no problem at all. It was a proper David Moyes team. They were okay, to be fair, West Ham, they were alright, they surprised me a bit than what I thought they would do, but it was just like blah blah Haller, do you know what I mean? They were so deep, and it was like they were inviting us on, because it was just they knew that they couldn't keep up with us. There was a point where Declan Rice went over to challenge something. I think he'd like put his hand on Van Dijk, and Van Dijk didn't even go down, and like the liner flagged it, and when he went up to the liner, he was blowing, he was absolutely knackered.
It was funny, wasn't it, because you said about the two lines, and like they were so so deep from the very first whistle, and yet Liverpool were still finding ways at times, just moving the ball really fast. Obviously Robertson got in a couple of times, nearly scored, put a decent ball across, and then, you know, penalty comes eventually. But I thought it was funny that, you know, I was watching it thinking, well, when you've got to come out at some point, surely. Like, is it going to be 60, is it going to be 75, is it going to be 80? And any time they did try and go forward, you know, Liverpool would just win it off them and catch them on the break, and they were all over the show. And it was funny because, you know, obviously the one Oxlade-Chamberlain scores, we were watching that, and like me and Kev Walsh were talking about it, and we were made up with each other. You know when you say something and then it happens, and we were both sort of talking about it going like, you know, it's mad now that basically a corner for the opposition has become a chance for Liverpool. And then we, you know, because how many times now, it's definitely a few that Liverpool are so good at breaking away, that they break away from an opposition corner and score. And it's unbelievable how good they are at it. And, you know, there's two fantastic balls in that goal as well. Henderson to Salah, and then Salah with that curled ball into Oxlade-Chamberlain's pass. Reminded me a little bit of Stevie's pass to Sturridge, Fulham away, a few seasons back. Lovely pass. And, like, it's funny as well, like, you know, obviously people... Some people have been having a little bit of a moan about Mo, but, you know, you saw his class again last night.
I said he was man of the match. So I'd done the post-match audio show last night with Neil Atkinson and Neil Dohan, and that argument there of who was man of the match. I mean, Neil Dohan went for Firmino, I went for Mo Salah, and I think I'm completely justified in my decision. I think he really stepped up, and I think what happened last night was what you saw last night is... This idea of everyone panicking that Sadio Mane is away, like there's nothing to worry about. And I think Mo Salah and Firmino absolutely relished the fact that they could step up to the mark last night and fill in for Mane. Divock Origi stepped up as well, all of them did, but especially Firmino and Salah, because as much as we're a team, they're also the front men, the forwards, they want to get goals, they do want to be the star, all of them want to be scoring, all of them want to be the main men, and everyone would argue that Mane's probably been the best out of the three of them this season, which is absolutely fine, but I thought they took the responsibility upon themselves, and I was just so, so happy with the performance of all of them all round, but especially Mo Salah last night. He just was such a mature performance for me.
And even when they get through, the bearded god that is Alisson is there between the sticks, just repelling everything that anyone can throw at us.
Makes it look so bloody easy. It's ridiculous.
We are such a great side currently. Listen, as you know by now, we always bang on about it, and we bang on about it for a reason, because we like it, we think it's good, we're proud of it. We do post-match stuff after every single Liverpool match. We do a post-match podcast, we do a post-match video. We'd like you to get onto them. The post-match video this time around as well is free. So here's a clip of it as usual, but if you like it, you can watch the full thing on YouTube this time around. We've had some issues with our servers. We are sorting them out. We are making them stronger and better and all the rest of it. But in the meantime, we are putting this one out for free. So watch the clip, and if you like it, watch the full thing on YouTube. We're breaking sort of records every week, it seems, right now. And the one today is that it's the first time ever in Liverpool's history that they've beat everyone in the league in one season other than 1890 something when they were in the second division. So it's the first time in the top flight. And now, I mean, that just underlines to me now that there's absolutely nothing to fear. We need 8 wins out of the 14 games remaining maximum. That requires City, obviously, to do the business week in, week out. And you just think, you know, we can start Liverpool now. The league is definitely ours, and it's just a matter of when.
And it's mad, isn't it? Because like, I've always been a sort of pessimist when it comes to all this kind of stuff, but you just can't help but like believe in them now, can you? You just don't doubt them in any way no more. And even like to the point we were saying beforehand, like, I didn't care about any of these records. I've never really cared about them. I'm starting to care about them because this team's that good. I want them to have every record they can possibly get because they deserve that now. Because they've got nothing else to prove. They're already going to win the league, but let's win it in absolute style, do you know what I mean? Like, I mean, they already will, but let's get every record that's going. And I think they will, to be fair.
Okay, that is the post-match pint. That is part of our video subscription service, or if you subscribe to The Lot, you also get that. The options are audio, video, and The Lot. And we do review and preview every single Liverpool match. We look at things in depth. We interview people as well. We do silly things. There's loads and loads and loads that makes up the Anfield app subscription. Check it out. Have a go. If you download the app as well, you can get some free tokens on there, which allows you to have a go of some of the premium content and see if it's for you. Hopefully it is, and hopefully you download it, and hopefully you subscribe, because that's what keeps all this thing going. And on the subject of supporting us and getting involved with what we do, we are going to Ireland on the 7th, 8th and 9th of February. So that's, it's not this weekend, the weekend after.
No, Belfast on the Friday, Dublin
not this
on
weekend, the weekend after. Not this weekend, the weekend.
Belfast on the Friday, Dublin on the Saturday, Cork on the Sunday. Do you know what? That's strategic, that if that's Craig Hammond in Dublin on the Saturday.
I don't think
Belfast on the Friday, Dublin on the Saturday. He's not, but Dublin on a Saturday's a boss at a night out, isn't it? But I've heard Cork's boss as well.
Yeah, I'm looking forward to Cork, home of Barry's tea, of course.
if anyone from Barry's is watching.
I mean,
take your man round the factory, he's really excited.
I am. I've plugged Barry's so many. I've rang Barry's, I've emailed Barry's. Someone sent me some Barry's today, which really made me day. Thanks, Sherry. And yeah, tickets are running low, by the way, on all of those gigs. So we're really looking forward to getting over there. In terms of who is going, Neil, of course, is going. I'm going. Josh is going. Paul Cope's going. John Milburn's going. Rob Gutman's going. I think that's it.
Oh, God, one night out.
What a lad. What a strong...
Oh, I envy... Actually, no, I don't know. I should say I don't envy
Ireland. What a strong Anfield rap lineup that is. We're going to have a big party, talk about the Reds, talk about how great the Reds are. We're going to get some of yous up on stage. We're going to play silly games. We're going to have a laugh. We're going to have a bevy. Honestly, the live shows are good. I remember way back when we did the first Anfield Rap live show in Bray in Ireland, and we were like, I was like, what the fuck is this? This is never going to work. A podcast live. But it does work. It's boss. And Neil's fantastic as well at holding it all together. Anyway, we've also... We're supposed to always ask for a daily question. I've been really shit at this. I keep forgetting. So the idea is put a question in the comments. We will read them and we'll pick one tomorrow. And then the people doing Talking Reds tomorrow will do it. Whoever did it yesterday did remember, so well in them. I think it was Mo and Fuad, maybe?
Yeah, well in them.
Yes, well in Mo and Fuad. And Josh has picked one of those. And the question he's gone for is, out of all the Anfield app people, who is the worst to watch the football with and why?
Are you going for? I haven't watched a match in the ground with many people from the Anfield app, because I sit on my own in my season ticket, so I actually haven't watched it live with anyone. Done a lot of like away stuff though, where I've watched it on the telly with people. No one really jumps to mind. I can't think of any off the top of my head. Have you got one? And then if you say that, then I'll have a little think. I'm just trying to...
I think worst is like a negative word, isn't it?
Like, do you know what I mean? I just don't like people who talk the whole way through it.
Like, I can tell you about experiences of watching football with people from the Anfield. Fairly recently, Villa away, I went with Ian Ryan, and we had a great time. I enjoyed it. Ian's a tough lad. But what was funny about it was, like, we had a seat sort of, the away section's weird at Villa now, it's sort of on the side. And it used to be behind the goal years ago, and, you know, much preferred there, to be honest. But yeah, sort of on the side. And we were fairly nearish the front, like. And when Liverpool score late on, and obviously win in the fashion that they win, I sort of, like, you know, was going mad and like, yeah, and then like turned to like celebrate with Ian. No, Ian. where the fuck's he gone? It's like virtually on the pitch. He'd like gone absolute miles to go and like get involved in this madness. I was like, go ahead, Eddie. And so it took me ages to find him. So that was quality. I wouldn't say like that was a bad thing at all.
I remember,
obviously this is going back a while, but because we haven't played Blackburn for a while for obvious reasons, but I remember going to Blackburn away, and Johnny Milburn was with us, and he'd had him heavy, it was fair to say, we all had. But like he went absolutely wild on some of the celebrations, went flying. I think he like quite badly did his knee.
Really?
And like, you know, you don't want to be taken down by John Milburn, absolutely. You know what I mean?
Absolutely not.
So there was that.
I haven't got many.
I don't think there's like, yeah, like I say, worst is quite negative, isn't it? So I can't really think of anyone where I'm like, oh, fuck off.
Craig Cannon loves a fall. I'll say that. Craig Cannon loves a fall. So when I went to Sheffield away, I just, because it was a sticky game, I knew what was going to happen. So like when it got to about 50, 60, I was like, right, I'm just going to get towards the middle because Craig was behind me, but like we were on the aisle of the steps and I was thinking, I know what's going to happen. Like got myself there and it went absolutely berserk when that Wijnaldum goal went in and Craig, as I thought, flew into the person right in front of him and that would be me. So I got myself out the way of Craig Cannon. And then there's little Patrick who works in our office. He's our team assistant, Patrick. He come the match, what match was it? I think it was Salzburg and home. He come with me on my auto cup. And he just like, he sang everything so, so, so loud. And I'm doing an audio project, it's out next week actually. And I was trying to record the crowd noise, you know, like all the singers, so you can hear like the crowd, but then all you can hear is, Liverpool, yeah, this is Patrick's playing God, they're international. It's lit, honestly.
I mean, he's from the North End, Pat, so yeah, you know, you're definitely getting a very Scouse rendition of all the songs if you're trying to record them.
It's funny, God love him.
Tough lad, we love him. That'll do as well, won't it?
That will do.
I think we've fired through everything there. So yeah, the Ireland tickets, if you go to theanfieldwrap.com/tourlive.
T-A-W, not tour as in going on tour.
Yeah, T-A-W live. You can get the tickets from there. It will take you through to the C Tickets website and you can get involved. Luke's stuff, as I say, look in the description. And for your app stuff, download the app, you can get involved for nothing. Post-match pint available for free. Post-match show available for free from last night as well. Get stuck in, because what a time to be alive. What a time to be a Red. Up the fucking Reds.